Welcome to AK Sharma Bio Classes. Please do subscribe the channel for more videos. In the previous section, we have studied microsporogenesis. We are going to have a very quick recap in this section also. So let us recall what is a microsporogenesis. Microsporogenesis is the formation of microspore from pollen mother cell through meiosis. Microsporogenesis is the formation of microspore from pollen mother cell through meiosis, meiotic division. The sporogenous cell divides meiotically and it gives the microspore tetrad. We have already seen in the previous section, pollen mother cell is diploid, and this diploid pollen mother cell undergo meiosis 1, and meiosis 1, we all know that this is reductional division, and here two microspore will be formed and both of them will be haploid, and they will further go meiosis 2, that is as similar to mitosis, and there will be formation of four haploid microspore, but all of them will be joined with each other, so they will form a tetrad of four haploid microspore. So they are not separated, they are joined with each other. So when the water in the tapetum dries, or tapetal shell dries, then anther dehiscence, and anther after dehiscence liberates all the four pollen grains separately, and all these four pollen grain will be haploid. So one microspore pollen mother cell will form four pollen grains, haploid pollen grain. This microsporogenesis occurs inside microsporangia, or we can also call it pollen sac of anther. There are four microspores will be formed from one microspore mother cell, and that will be arranged in tetrad, and all four microspores will be functional. Microspore give rise to male gametophyte, and male gametophyte is nothing but pollen grains, and pollen grains are the first cells of male gametophyte. Let us discuss the structure of a mature pollen grain in this section in detail. Structure of pollen grain. As we discussed, pollen grains are the first cells of male gametophyte. You all know that tapetum is the innermost wall of the anther, and when tapetal cells gets used up, because they are nutritive in nature, they have a dense cytoplasm and full of nutritive molecule granules, so these all will get used up during the formation of microspores, pollen grains, and the anther becomes a dry structure, and this liberates the pollens by dehiscence of the anther. Anther will rupture and all the pollen grains will come out, and each mature pollen grain will look like this. Let us discuss the structure of a pollen grain. You can see the pollen grains have two walls. This is the outer wall, this is the outer wall, and this is inner wall. Outer wall is called exine. And inner wall is called, what do you call it? Entine. So there are two walls. There are two walls of pollen grain, exine and entine. Let us discuss one by one. The exine is the outermost wall, the outer wall of pollen grain, and it is made up of sporopollenin. Sporopollenin is the hardest natural substance which is present in the outer wall of pollen grain, and it is very helpful to the pollen grain because it protects the pollen grain from heat, or you can say all abiotic climatic stress and chemicals. It protects the pollen grain from heat and chemical, so we can say that it is heat and chemical resistant substance. Sporopollenin is heat and chemical resistance, so there is no effect of heat, temperature, chemicals like acid, base, salts and other chemicals, so it will not affect the outer wall or pollen grain. Let us see the inner wall. Inner wall is entine. Entine is inner layer or inner wall. Entine is inner wall, and it is made up of cellulose and pectin, and this layer also helps in germination of pollen tube. When pollen tube formation takes place, this helps the pollen tube to get formed. And two more structure we can see in this pollen grain. One of the first two cells are there, one part that is vegetative cells and another one is generative cells. Vegetative cells and generative cells. Pollen, mature pollen grains have two cells. Large one is called vegetative cells and a small one is called generative cell. This is a small one, generative cell, and this one is large one, vegetative cell. Let us discuss about them also. So vegetative cell, you can see there, in vegetative cell there is huge cytoplasm and it contains fat, protein and starch granules, so it is full of nutritive granules, and it germinates into this vegetative cell, give rise to pollen tube for fertilization. We will see how it germinates into a pollen tube. Let us see the pollen here. This is pollen grain, and pollen grain, this generative cells, and this is vegetative cells, or vegetative cells, another name is tube cells. So tube cells, that is why, because it gives a pollen tube, that is why it is also known as tube cells. See this tube. So this pollen tube will come out, and this pollen tube will come out, will extend outside with generative cells also. Generative cells means the nucleus which is present in the generative cells. Generative cells, so it will further, generative cells further, it divides mitotically and it gives two male gametes. It gives two male gametes. Generative cell, this generative cell may further divides into two male gametes. If generative cell, generative nucleus further divides into two male gametes, then this becomes three-celled stage. But here it is two-celled. Here this is two-celled stage. Here it is two-celled stage. Why it is two-celled? Because one generative nucleus is there, one generative cell is there, and one male gamete. This is two-celled stage because there is one generative nucleus, or one is pollen tube nucleus, so pollen tube and one generative nucleus. But generative nucleus further divides mitotically and it gives here two male gametes. It gives here two male gametes, and when it gives two male gametes, it becomes three-celled stage. It becomes three-celled. Three-celled. Why three-celled? Because there is one tube and two male gametes are there. There is two male gamete and one tube. So this is called three-celled stage. And most of the plants are in two-celled stage. When they are in two-celled stage, pollination takes place. 60% about 60% angiospermic plant, the pollination occurs in two-celled stage. But some of the plants, it may occur in three-celled stage also. Pollination can occur when the pollen grain is two-celled stage. We have seen two-celled stage means one tube nucleus and one generative nucleus, one generative cells, one tube cells and one generative cells. But when it becomes three-celled, so in three-celled stage mein kya hota hai? One tube and two male gametes will be there, and we have seen that most of the plant or angiospermic plant, how much? Approximately 60% angiospermic plant pollination occurs in two-celled stage. Now let us see one more structure in the pollen grain, that is germ pore. That is germ pore. When you see the enlarged form of pollen grain, then you will find the structures like this, and you can see in this structure here at this part, here in this part, the outer layer exine has no deposition of sporopollenin. There is no deposition of sporopollenin. On exine layer, that is outer wall of pollen grain, and such area is called germ pore. The area where there is no deposition of sporopollenin on exine, such area is called germ pores, and germ pores also helps pollen tube to come out. In some pollen it may be one, in some pollen it may be more than one. Okay, now let us discuss the significance of pollen grains. For significance, we are using it as food supplement. Why we are using this in food supplement? Because they are rich in carbohydrate and fats, so a great source of energy. So it can be used as tablets and syrup to increase stamina. Stamina means the performance level. So it can be pollen grains, tablets or syrups, or in other forms it can be taken by the athletes and during race horse to increase the stamina, to increase the performance. Another use, it can be used as pollen creams. It is used to protect from sun. It can be used to protect from the sun. Sun means ultraviolet rays, because pollen grain does not get harmed by ultraviolet rays. So because of this property, we can use these for sun protection. And third one is, it can be preserved as pollen bank, because pollen grains are the male gamete, and male gamete can be used in the fertilization, and so it can be preserved for artificial select or selective breeding, and it can be cryopreserved. What do you mean by cryopreservation? Cryopreservation ka matlab hai to preserve any gamete or any substance at minus 196 degree Celsius, minus 196 degree Celsius in liquid nitrogen, and this is called cryopreservation. If we preserve anything at minus 196 degree Celsius temperature in liquid nitrogen, this is called cryopreservation, and this male gametes can be preserved for artificial breeding or selective breeding in future. You can see the pollen products and the energy shake. In the form of energy shake, it can be used in bee pollen creams. You can see, isn't it? आप देख सकते हो कि एनर्जी शेक के रूप में यूज हो रहा है, पॉलन पावर के फॉर्म में हो रहा है, बी पॉलन के फॉर्म में है. पॉलन, दीज आर द पॉलन प्रोडक्ट्स टू बी यूज्ड और आर बीइंग यूज्ड बाय द पीपल फॉर देयर डिफरेंट पर्पस. नाउ देयर इज एनी डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ पॉलन ग्रेन्स? यस, डेफिनेटली. एंड एलर्जी, पॉलन कैन कॉज एलर्जी. And this allergy, so this is the harmful effect of pollen. This is harmful effect of pollen, because pollen grain causes allergy to some people. So this is harmful effect of pollen. So we have studied in this section the structure of pollen grain and significance of pollen grain. Pollen grains can be used as food supplements. Pollen grains can be used as pollen creams, and it can be stored in pollen banks. Structure of pollen grain. Pollen grain is made up of two walls, exine and entine. Two cells, vegetative cell and generative cell. The vegetative cell give rise to pollen tube, and generative cell give rise to male gametes. And there is deposition of sporopollenin on exine. Sporopollenin is heat and chemical resistance, and germ pore is the area where there is no deposition of sporopollenin on exine layer. So in this section we have completed, and in the next section we will study megasporogenesis and the structure of megasporangium, isn't it? So keep watching the videos and do subscribe the channel for more videos. Thank you.